Today's workout, 3 rounds for max reps, 1 minute of goblet squats, 1 minute of kettlebell swings, 1 minute of pogo hops, 1 minute of high pulls, 1 minute of object facing burpees, and 1 minute of rest. Lauren will take you through the warm-up, Owen will take you through the skills and the workout, and Amy will cool it all down with a stretch.
All right, so we're gonna get warm. We're gonna start off with lunges with a twist and push-ups with a twist. We're gonna work for 15 seconds, you're gonna break for 10. We're gonna repeat that a ton of times. Here we go, I'll walk you through everything. So we're starting off with a lunge with a twist. 3, 2, 1, go. Lunge backwards, twist over the front leg, reset, do that again. Our goal here is really just to prep the spine and the hips and the legs. 3, 2, 1, shake it out, take a break. If you want to, you don't have to, but if you want to, you can grab some weight and do that. Otherwise, we're getting down on the ground for push-ups. Go! Push down, or push up, and then twist one hand towards the ceiling. Come back down, do it again, switch hands. 2, 1, take a break. Going back to the lunges with the twist. 2, 1, and go. Five more seconds. 2, 1, rest, 10 seconds. We're going push up with the twist again. 3, 2, 1, push up with a twist. 2, 1, and relax. Very nice. You can't see it as well, but she is standing over a seam between some mats here. The goal is to always leave one foot here for the lateral lunge. 3, 2, 1. Looks like a Cossack squat. She's gonna step out, lunge down, feet come together before the other leg goes out and down. And you're gonna keep going, trying to get as low as possible. The heels stay flat. 3, 2, 1, and break. We're gonna go to that medicine ball or your dumbbell or kettlebell at home, whatever you got. Could be a backpack. You're gonna put it over your head for a push press. 3, 2, 1, up, dip drive, press it out. Really try to get that head through. You really have to push that object as far back as possible. 3, 2, 1, take a break. Back to the lateral lunge. 3, 2, 1, and go. Obviously, if you want to make this a little harder, you can hold that medicine ball at your chest. Otherwise, we'll just stay here. 5 seconds. 2, 1, rest. 10 seconds to catch your breath. Going back to that med ball push press. And 3, 2, 1, go. Dip, drive. Shallow, shallow dip. It's like a quarter or an eighth of a squat before you extend violently to lock that ball over your head. And break. Cool. Next up, Lauren's favorite, the rocket launcher. 3, 2, 1, and go. But once you find the rhythm, it's kind of fun. Maybe the first round, and then it's not fun. The second and third and fourth and fifth round. If you've ever done any of the HIIT workouts. And relax, 10 seconds to catch your breath. Now we're gonna work only at the top half of the push-up. Come down until your arms are 90 degrees and then push back up. 3, 2, 1, go. Solid. Keep the body in a straight line, ears, shoulders, hip, knee, and the ankle. Everything is solid. And break. All right, we're gonna repeat all of that again. With the rocket launcher in 3, 2, 1, and go. Thank you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Last time, we're going to do half of the push-up. 2, 1, and go. Seconds and rest. All right, we're gonna do a couple more things to warm up our abs. If you have a kettlebell like Lauren has here, you're gonna place it on one side of the body. We're gonna do some side bends. So the goal here is the weighted side is gonna reach down towards the ground as much as possible, and then you're gonna come up. If you don't have a handheld object and you have the medicine ball or a weight plate, you can do this. Put it on top of your head. And then do the same thing. Tilt towards one side as much as you can and come back up. Whoa! Say her eyebrows, because it's still just as difficult, or I would argue a little more difficult. 3 rounds of 30 seconds per side. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Bending over as much as possible. You can drop the head too and then come up. There you go. If you've got lower back issues, you may want to be a little more careful here and not challenge that range as much because you will be firing off that low back, but that's precisely why this is a good movement for you. If you've taken any of my Zoom kettlebell classes, you'll know that this is all we ever do in those classes. Surprise, surprise. 3, 2, 1, switch sides. Same thing on the other side. Challenge that range, feel a stretch in the obliques and maybe part of the hip before you stand back up. Keeping the butt, the shoulders, and the head in line or against the wall if you're lucky enough to do this against the wall. Switching to the original side in 3, 2, 1, go. Use the med ball. Take your time with it if you're not used to it. If you feel this, it's probably because of that. Like later, like tomorrow, the day after. Really try to like, yeah, curl as much as you can. 3, 2, 1, switch sides. You think about dragging the ball against the wall too. Funky, right? 10 more seconds and then you get to go back to your kettlebell. 3, 2, 1, switch sides. Back to the original side. Lauren here is just showing you the different options because we are in the gym and we have the equipment available, but to show you that if you're only limited by your imagination, you can still get this work done regardless of what it is. Switching sides in 4, 3, 2, 1. Last time, last side. Really trying to get those obliques, those backs fired and on, ready to go. Seconds left. Five, four, three, two, one, relax. Very nice.
Today we're using a kettlebell. The goblet squat is essentially a front squat. Have the load somewhere in front of the collarbones, your elbows directly underneath the object for support. And your goal is, like any other squat, stand up tall, try to break parallel if possible, but only go as low as you can keep your back flat and your heels down, stand back up. If range of motion is an issue or pain in the knees when squatting is an issue, then try to find a target to actually sit on. We'd like today's kettlebell swing to be perfectly vertical overhead by using the legs and popping the hips. The pogo hop is jumping laterally and immediately rebounding back to the start position. Use your object or line. The sumo deadlift high pull starts with the bell on the ground each and every time. You're going to use the power of your legs and your hips to drive the bell up, shrugging your shoulders and getting your elbows high and outside. And finally, the bell-facing burpee or object-facing burpee is doing a burpee while facing your object. Jump over, turn around, and do it again. Those are the skills. Grab your water and get your music started.
Yeah. So I'm not saying. Go Hawks, baby.